In this video, we will start to describe how we calculate the standard cell potential for a galvanic cell. In the last video, we looked at how we can determine when we're given reduction half reactions, how we can determine what is the best oxidizing agent and what is the best reducing agent. The shortcut version of all of that is that when we are given two half reactions, the more positive reduction potential will remain as the reduction half reaction. So for example, if we look at our two half reactions we used in the last video, we had gold being reduced to the solid, gold ion being reduced to solid with a reduction potential of 1.498 volts. And we had nickel 2 plus ion being reduced down to nickel solid. That one had a reduction potential of negative 0.257 volts. So we determined that gold ion is the easiest to reduce, therefore the best oxidizing agent. The statement that's mentioned up here, the first bullet, that the more positive reduction potential, that is the gold half reaction, will remain as the reduction half reaction. And that's because gold ion is easier to reduce as the best oxidizing agent. The more negative or less positive reduction potential, as is the case with our nickel ion reaction, that equation needs to be reversed. And so this will now be written as the oxidation of nickel. And become a positive oxidation potential of 0.257 volts. And that's because we determined that nickel solid was the best reducing agent, the easiest to oxidize of that list. So the net result is when you're given two half reactions, the more positive reduction potential will remain as reduction. The more negative or less positive reduction potential will be reversed to generate the oxidation half reaction. When you add your reduction and oxidation half reaction potentials together, we get our standard cell potential. Anytime we have a positive standard cell potential, it means our reaction is product favored. So remember, like we saw in the thermodynamics chapter, anytime we're talking about standard quantities, those are related to equilibrium and will determine if our reaction is reactant or product favored at equilibrium. So if we get a positive standard cell potential, that means we have a product favored battery. Our reaction will go forward to reach equilibrium until our battery dies. So it turns out batteries die once they reach equilibrium. A couple of ways that that can happen. Sorry about that. Don't know what's happening there. Battery can die either when your salt bridge dries out. So in the case of the lab experiment, when you're using a piece of string, if it's not soaked well enough or long enough, that salt bridge can dry out. As soon as the ions can't travel back and forth, your battery would die. Or if your anode or cathode compartment runs out of reactant. If a half reaction can't run anymore, the battery can't run anymore. So the net result of all of our discussion so far is that when I give you two half reactions, you want the combination of half reactions that will give the most positive overall standard cell potential. If you flip the wrong equation, you will get a negative cell potential. So easy way to fix it, flip them both, and you get a positive cell potential. So remember, our equation, our calculation for the standard cell potential is adding the oxidation potential to the reduction potential. And as long as that's a positive value, we have a product favored reaction. All right, let's put all of this together in a practice calculation. So I'm going to work through example number one here. I'm going to ask you to work through two and three. The answers are on the next slide. So I want to make a galvanic cell using copper and chromium as my two half reactions. So again, notice all half reactions are given as reduction with our reduction potentials. The moral of the story of our shortcut we just discussed is the standard cell potential that is more positive, I want to keep as reduction. So I'm not going to make any changes to my copper reaction. Since chromium is less positive, or in this case more negative, I want to make that my oxidation reaction. So my anode, where oxidation occurs, will be the chromium half reaction. Chromium will be oxidized to the 3+ ion, and it will lose 3 electrons. That will now have an oxidation potential of a positive 0.744 volts. My cathode, where reduction is going to occur, will be the copper 2+ ion being reduced down to copper metal once it gains 2 electrons. I apologize for my handwriting today, copper solid. So nothing about the copper half reaction changes. I keep the reaction as is, and I'm going to keep the reduction potential. So easy way to set up my calculation, if I keep my half reactions written like this, I can literally just do my addition math right underneath it. So realize that I'm adding oxidation to reduction. And when I do this here, plugging this into my calculator, I get a total standard cell potential of 1.081. What about sig figs? So think about the math we did. We just added these two potentials together. That means we're going by least decimal places. These both go to 3. So my answer goes to 3 decimal places with units of volts. I have an overall positive value here. That tells me that I have a product favored reaction. So if I combine these two in my galvanic cell, I will generate a voltage. The reaction will run on its own. And I didn't ask for this next question, but good to review. And that is to write the overall balanced equation. Remember that for balancing, we are looking at what happens with electrons. So I have a total of 3 electrons from chromium, 2 electrons from copper. In order to balance this equation, remember I need to have my electrons cancel. So I'm going to multiply my chromium equation through by 2 and my copper equation through by 3. Notice when I do that, what will be my coefficient on my electrons? If you said 6, that is absolutely correct. So another thing that I want to review and clarify, because we will start getting into calculations soon, the value of N is our moles of electrons. And again, that value is determined when our electrons cancel out when we balance our equation. And so for this set of equations of half reactions, our value of N is 6. Now to finish balancing, again, I'm multiplying 2 through by my chromium equation and a 3 for my copper. And then I make sure that that 2 carries through for all substances so that my atoms also balance. Both chromiums have a coefficient of 2, both coppers have a coefficient of 3, so my atoms balance. And now notice when we look at our charges, I have a total of a 6 plus on the reactant side and a total of a 6 plus charge on the product side. So both atoms and charges balance. So again, I encourage you to try the same thing for numbers 2 and 3 for those combinations. And as good practice, write the balanced overall equation. For the calculation of the cell potential, those answers are listed here on the next slide. And example 17.4 is a great one to work at this point to practice.